Seaboard Airline number 544 is a coal-burning steam locomotive. Coal is a fuel of choice for most railroads in the eastern part of the United States. So how does coal make this locomotive move? It begins in the firebox. The firebox has a few different layers. On the inside, you've got the burning coal, burning at 2,000 degrees Fahrenheit. Surrounding that, on all sides except the bottom, you have a layer of boiling water. Then the outside, you've got this steel. The fire by itself doesn't make the train move. Its only job is to turn this water into steam as quickly as possible. That steam builds up in the boiler. You can think of that like if you blow up a balloon full of air. Now, I have to hold on to this balloon, because if I let go, the air inside the balloon will escape. The steam in this boiler also wants to escape. It's pressurized to about 200 pounds per square inch. It wants to get out, and we're going to let it, but we're going to make it do some work first. When I want to move the train, I'll pull on the throttle in the cab. That lets steam flow down a pipe into these cylinders. Inside the cylinder is a piston, about that big around and that thick. That steam comes down and it pushes that piston all the way to the other end of the cylinder. Then it escapes out a hole and out the stack. And the escaping of the steam out of the stack makes that characteristic chug sound we know and love so much about steam locomotives. That steam's gone, but more steam is going to come from the boiler and push the other side of the piston back the way it came, and again, escape out the stack. So you've got this piston on this side, moving back and forth like this. You've got another one on the other side, working kind of like this. These are connected to all these rods and cranks on the wheels, and these work a lot like pedaling a bicycle. In a typical day, a steam locomotive might run up to 150 miles and burn 10 tons of coal and turn 20,000 gallons of water into steam. All that water and coal comes from the tender right behind the locomotive where I'm standing. This tender holds about 10 tons of coal, enough for a full day's worth of work, but only about 6,000 gallons of water. As often as every 30 miles, you'd have to stop by one of those big wooden water tanks you see in old westerns, open up this hatch on top of the tender, pull down the spout, and fill it back up. There's a crew of two people who work up here, the engineer and the fireman. Now the firemen, their most obvious job was shoveling the coal. For shovel coal, I'm gonna grab my shovel off this hook, lean back on this post so I don't fall over, the engine's rocking back and forth down the tracks, step on this pedal, which opens up the firebox doors, and then I throw the coal into the firebox. I'll typically shovel about two scoops at a time, and then wait 20 seconds, and then shovel two more, and wait 20 seconds, and shovel two more, and repeat that through the course of the day. The coal inside the firebox is supposed to be a thin, even layer. You don't want any holes, you don't want any piles, so I have to be distributing this coal, mostly by memory, to keep a nice thin layer of coal in the firebox. Shoveling coal is the most visible part of the fireman's job, but the most important part is actually keeping the water level in the right part of the boiler. This sight glass should have a glass tube that would fill up with water and show me the water level. Too much water, I'll get water into the cylinder, which can do a lot of damage to a locomotive. And too little water will cause the top of the firebox to overheat and melt, causing a boiler explosion, which launches everything above the wheels up to a mile away. That would be bad for me. I also have to keep enough pressure in the boiler to give the engine the power it needs. Pumping cold water in the boiler lowers the pressure. Shoveling coal into the fire increases the pressure. So I'm balancing coal, water, and how much steam the engineer is using to keep a consistent pressure and a consistent water level in the boiler. The engineer has three levers to drive the train. The Johnson bar controls if we're going forwards or backwards and whether we have more high-speed power or low-speed torque. The throttle puts steam into the cylinders to make the train move. And the air brake lets the train slow down or stop. It took the simplest things to move this 86-ton machine down the rails. Just coal, water, a roaring fire, and a lot of sweat.